Rival footy fans brawl at Marvel Stadium. What is the AFL doing about its crowd behaviour controversy?
Breaking overnight, an 18-year-old man shot on a Surfers Paradise balcony.
An ex-detective's relief at the death of one of Australia's most evil criminals. He takes us inside the cult known as the family.
Why everyone still has an opinion on Amanda Knox, how her body language has been scrutinised on her trip back to Italy.
Fairy tale finish. An entire country gets behind a basketball team, cheering them all the way to the NBA final.
Why the Queen is selling her villa in Malta, where she and Prince Philip lived as newlyweds.
And Elton John, Fleetwood Mac, U2 and Shawn Mendes, the biggest artists on the planet, gearing up to come down under. Today, Sunday, the 16th of June, 2019. Yes, Elton is coming. Good morning and welcome today. Thanks for your company. Good to see you guys.
Good to see you too, team. How good is Shawn Mendes, by the way? Great young artist.
He's amazing.
Great young artist, and he's going to be coming out here too. Elton John's doing 32 shows in Australia.
I know, and in 32. Places that don't normally get big names.
But he did that in his last tour too. Yeah. So he went to Wollongong, he went up to, you know, the far north Queensland, finishing his tour in Parramatta. That's so great. He loves Australia, so do we.
You know, I've never seen Elton John in concert. So.
Oh, it's amazing.
I know. You've got to go. My last chance, right?
Yeah, you really can't miss this one.
I know.
Otherwise, you're stuck with Rocket Man.
All right, we've got plenty of news this morning, so let's grab all the headlines with Jayne.
Thanks, guys. Good morning. An ugly all-in brawl has marred an AFL match in Melbourne, the latest in a string of violent fan incidents prompting calls for increased security. Lana Murphy is live for us outside Marvel Stadium this morning. Good morning to you, Lana. Run us through what happened. All right, Lana Murphy there. Thank you. A driver's alleged reckless run from the law has come to an end on the other side of the country. It's alleged the 27-year-old escaped officers in February by dodging closing boom gates at a train crossing in Perth. Glenn Smith was finally arrested in Canberra, wanted over traffic and stealing offences, and his car was found in rural New South Wales. And a huge outdoor painting has been unveiled at the Eiffel Tower. The giant image shows interlaced hands, recognising the charities that rescue refugees who are attempting to cross from Africa into Europe. The 15,000 square metre work used biodegradable paint made with chalk and charcoal.
Oh, that's extraordinary.
Beautiful. Quite a feat, yeah. Gorgeous. There we go.
Nice little, get a good selfie of that, go on top of the Eiffel Tower.
And
then
yeah.
just get a selfie about the art on the floor. It's a twofer.
Fabulous. Well, it's the only reason to climb the Eiffel Tower.
Well, no, you served the Eiffel Tower. Why go there? I just want to climb that building so I can get a shot of the floor now. It's a good-looking floor in France.
All right, let's check in with Clint now, who is waking up with a beautiful view of Melbourne this morning.
A very good morning to you, DC and Ali. We are chilling this morning right in the heart of Melbourne, would you believe? I'm in an igloo, but we're at the Winter Village at Federation Square. Finally, a job where I get perks. I see Tim diving into food and drink. I'm here at the Winter Village. We're going to chill out here. But first, let's get a hit of sport this morning. We start with cricket because Australia were again impressive at the World Cup overnight. In fact, we've climbed to the top of the Cricket World Cup table after a dominant 87-run win over Sri Lanka. So until I see you again, it's time to chill out in this here igloo. Right in the middle of Melbourne. It's quite a nice setup, don't you think?
In this here igloo. You're even speaking like someone who lives in an igloo now. All right, mate, we'll see you soon. Wow, Clint's having a good time. Let's see what Tim's doing, because I don't know how he can top that. He's in Sydney.
You know he's going to try, though, don't you?
Yeah, I'm not going to, no. Freezing cold, and it's pouring rain.
Yeah, you lose.
Welcome to Mrs. Macquarie's chair. Yeah, thanks, Ali. Thank you very much. Good morning, everybody. We are coming to you from Mrs. Mac's chair in Sydney this morning. It's looking a little bit wet this morning and it, of course, is very chilly, but we're going to have a little bit of fun and we've found a really good way to warm up. Not just the lovely Parle vegan coffee that we are enjoying here this morning, but you might be able to notice a few tri-colours going around or tri-stripes.
Well, I think, you know, Tim, you know, so $1 per kilometre. You should do 2
Tim.
Laps.
Oh, I was going to say, let's get make him do 100. I'll chuck 100 down if Tim
really?
Does 100Ks.
He's meaner than me this morning, Tim.
Okay, yeah, I know. Ali, come on, step it up. Come on.
I'll have a few more coffees and we'll see how we go.
8Ks. Okay, we'll see how we go. A few more coffees.
All right, take it easy, man. Warm up. Coming up, why women are retiring with half the amount of money as men and how to make sure you are set up properly for the future.
And making dreams come true. How kids growing up playing basketball in Australia are going on to dominate the NBA.
Welcome back. I wish that the background smelt as good as it looked. Now, we are regarded as the most successful multicultural nation in the world.
But offering newcomers a slice of the great Australian dream is often easier said than done. Until now, because a program is underway in Sydney, it's breaking ground by simply baking bread.
Wow, such a great story. Feel-good story for the weekend,
beautiful.
Too.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
All right, well, still to come, an ex-detective takes us inside the cult known as the family.
And the fairy tale finish that every Canadian was hoping for, the magic that happens when a community gets behind a sporting team.
Channel 9 is celebrating 60 years in Queensland with a massive 60 days of thanks.
And our loyal viewers can win a share of $60,000 in cash and prizes.
Each night this week, Todd's Hi-Fi gives away $1,000 of Yamaha equipment.
To win, simply watch 9 News weeknights at 6 and look out for the code words.
Thanks for your company this Sunday morning. How can women have half the amount of money as men when they retire? And what can we do to change it?
Well, the first female-owned superannuation fund has been created. And CEO and co-founder of Verve Super, Christina Hobbs, joins us now. Christina, thanks for joining us this morning. Why do women have less money than men?
Being paid less throughout their careers, taking time out of the workforce to care. All of this compounds and leads to women having less savings in retirement.
Do we need to see more from governments and from industry to make like a fairer super system in place for women?
Yeah, we certainly need to be looking at the policies that are in place.
Thanks, Christina. Really, really great initiative. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Right, let's grab all the news now with Jayne. It's right on 7:30.
Thanks, guys. Good morning again. An ugly all-in brawl has marred an AFL match in Melbourne. Rival fans clashing at Marvel Stadium after the Carlton Western Bulldogs game. Activists in Hong Kong say they will keep fighting against a proposed extradition law despite the government suspending the bill indefinitely. Hong Kong's leader backed down after a week of violent protests, but demonstrators say they're not done yet. A pair of snakes have woken from their winter hibernation, captured mating on the veranda of a home north of Byron Bay. The wild reptiles started their deed on the deck before moving up to the ceiling of the Mullumbimby home.
We're dancing on the ceiling. What a feeling.
Actually quite an unusual sight for this time of year because the official mating season starts in spring. My sister sent me that video. She filmed that yesterday.
Oh, wow. This is her house.
It's not her house. It's the house of her husband's uncle and auntie.
Yeah, but it's not their house anymore. It's their snake's house.
No, but apparently they'd never seen anything like this.
I didn't realise that's how they... Anyway.
Neither did I. But there you go. You learned
something new. Snake porn there for your morning. I hope you enjoy your Weet-Bix, everybody.
Thanks, DC.
You were going to save him, but then you didn't.
Yeah.
You know what? When have I ever saved him?
I just recommend you clear your browser, Jayne.
Good morning, Clint.
Snake porn, it's very hard to follow, a very hard act to follow. Anyway, we are on the doorstep of the city this morning, Federation Square, where this fabulous winter village has been set up. I'll get to more on that very shortly. First, though, let's check in on your sport headlines, and we begin at the Cricket World Cup, England, in fact. Mitch Stark has showed why he's one, if not the most damaging bowler in world cricket. Very cool surrounds in Melbourne.
Are they heated, Clint?
They are. There are very, very big heaters.
Oh,
can
good.
I tell you that right?
Good. Oh, really? Well, that's nice, because you seem very cold.
He seems very cold.
Why don't you duck back inside one and we'll get some weather with Tim, who's not at all feeling the weather
that's
here
what
in Sydney.
Thank you.
No, not at all, guys. A little dreary here in Sydney this morning. Some low-lying cloud hanging over the Sydney Harbour Bridge there. But me, well, I'm just getting into feeling the burn here. No, don't adjust your television sets. You are not watching Aerobics Oz style from back in the 80s. We are just getting set for our Adidas Run for the Oceans event being staged here at Mrs. Macquarie's chair today. And yeah, so it's raining, whatever. That's all right.
What are
these
you
people
doing,
don't mind.
Tim?
Everyone's just really
doing?
Stretching and you're just sort of like moving back and forth. Are you dancing?
Do you want to know the truth?
Yeah.
Do you want to know the truth?
Yeah, I want
you guys,
the truth.
You guys talked to Clint. You talked to Clint for so long that I was actually down, really stretching, and I'm exhausted already. So.
Well, coming up, why all eyes are in fact on Amanda Knox as she returns to Italy for the first time since being cleared of murder. And what does it take to get into the NBA? The Australians who are showing kids around the country that no dream is too big.
Fish and chips with a side of poison.
Totally lost my voice.
The restaurant stuff-up that could have wiped out a family.
It's like acid.
They thought it was vinegar.
But beware, because vinegar isn't always what you think it is.
It was oven grill cleaner.
Plus, story dogs helping kids read, the animal logic getting results, and the push for pooches in all schools.
Changing lives, one dog at a time.
A Current Affair Monday.
It's basketball's greatest age and Aussie athletes are taking it by storm.
Yeah, we're talking about the NBA and homegrown superstars who have made it their own. Matt, I mean, it's also very impressive, isn't it? It's such a fun sport. So how hard is it, not for you and I because we're really short, Matt, but for anybody else who's slightly taller to make it in the NBA?
Oh, it's extremely difficult.
Thanks for joining us this morning.
Thank you for having me.
See you, buddy. Coming up, why it's harder to get away with serial murders in the era of smartphones. There's a bit of a jump there.
It was. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to laugh at the thought of serial killers. It was more the jump.
It was the jump between the two.
It was the jump.
Yeah.
Plus, do we need to rethink arresting low-risk bail offenders? The top cops saying they should get off scot-free. And why the Queen is selling her beloved first home with Prince Philip.
Welcome back. It is great to have your company this morning. Thanks so much. That was just such an interesting story before about all those basketball players and how much money Ben Simmons is going to make in the next 5 years. $230 million.
Before sponsorship. So you can imagine you add that, you're doubling that amount of money. It's, if only you were taller.
Yeah. It's like that rap song says, I wish I was a little bit taller. Because maybe we would have all had the chance of...
Well, is it just the height, though? I mean, let's
I've
see.
I've seen your ball skills.
Why did you laugh at that?
I didn't.
Why would you laugh at that?
I didn't know we had the Harlem Globetrotters here and I saw him dribble a ball.
You couldn't remember
why,
the
why did you have to hesitate before you said, did I dribble?
Was it the ball that he dribbled? I mean, I don't know. Who's to know?
Wow, I am being slammed for my sports skills. Here's the top stories on today. She's never it's like Stomp in here. Remember that group Stomp from the 90s?
It was awesome, buddy.
Yeah, that was unreal. All right, let's get some news now with Jayne.
Queensland police are trying to track down a gunman who shot a teenager who was just standing on the balcony of a Surfers Paradise hotel. For more on this, we're joined by Catherine Foran. Good morning to you, Catherine. What more do we know? Catherine, thank you. There are revelations this morning that the eldest of two brothers who were shot during a counter-terror operation on the Victoria-New South Wales border tried to leave Australia last year. Josh Clavell, who was shot along with his brother Joel on Wednesday, reportedly tried to fly out of Sydney but was stopped by authorities. The two brothers have not been charged. Well, he was a record breaker in his heyday, but even now, Babe Ruth is continuing to write his name into the record books. A jersey belonging to the famous New York Yankees baseball star selling at auction for nearly $8 million.
$8 million.
$8 million for something you can never wear.
I don't know if we've got some. Could we just play some of that footage of Babe Ruth again? Because what a specimen of... Like, it's interesting to see how sportsmen have changed over the years.
Gosh,
look,
isn't it?
Look at how he runs. Look at how, like... how kind of what you would say by today's standard, how unfit he is. And yet there he is, one of the greatest of all times. And an inspiring figure still to Americans that they'll buy a shirt of his for $8 million.
Yeah, incredible.
Yeah, right? Mm. He looks not very happy there, though. Who is, though, is Clint with some sport.
Wouldn't it be awesome to go back in time and see some of these spectacular historical sports people? Babe Ruth did amazing things in the game of baseball. We're chilling out in the heart of Melbourne this morning at the Winter Village. But first, let's get some sport for you this morning, because Australia's cricketers are doing great things at the World Cup. In fact, we've now soared to the top of the World Cup table after what was a really dominant 87-run win over Sri Lanka. And the Brumbies have warmed up for their Super Rugby quarterfinal with a steamrolling 40 points to 27 win over the Reds. There you have it, DC and Ali. It's back to you. That's the latest sport.
It's good to see a man in an igloo again, isn't it? No, you don't see that every morning. I mean, he's really kicking back in that igloo. The igloo life. Good on you, Clint.
With the heater.
Yeah, you know, igloo with the heater. I mean, most places where you'd have an igloo, that would melt, but not in Melbourne.
It's not too authentic, though. Hey, let's check in now with Tim, who I think he's struggling more with the weather this morning. Ooh. Poor old Tim.
Oh, why?
Make it, Tim.
Here we go.
Woohoo!
There he is, the scarf.
Oh, Timmy.
All right, see you then, mate.
In 2007, an American university student became the most talked about woman in the world.
So this week, Amanda Knox has returned to Italy for the first time since she was released from prison. So for more, we're joined now by the human lie detectors, Steve Van Apperen. Steve, great to have you on the show. So Amanda Knox is attending a criminal justice meeting in Italy. So how do you think, after all this time and everything she's been through and the scrutiny she was under, she'll be received by the public over there?
She was portrayed as a sex-crazed femme fatale who had multiple partners, and they called her Foxy. You know, it had all these terminologies for her and whatnot. And see, sometimes people listen to that.
So Amanda Knox was probably advised to try and be as calm as she is, don't show too much emotion, and yet we projected onto that is that she was cold, or that these names like Foxy Noxy were blown up by the tabloids, adding more pressure on her so she couldn't react even more. So, you know, as a body language expert, how did that affect her case?
You know, you've got to be very careful about drawing guilt on how a person simply reacts, because like I said, everyone reacts differently to different situations.
Did it surprise you when she announced that she was returning to Italy? Because they don't have double jeopardy laws over there. And I mean, while it seems very doubtful, there is always the chance, I guess, that she could be arrested again.
I think that's highly unlikely. And even her attorney doesn't think that's the case.
Steve, great to have your company this morning. If you really want to watch a documentary on this, it's a great
phenomenal
insight
watch
into this case and why the trial by media really damaged her. So it's fascinating, isn't it?
Yeah.
All right, looking for a royally big break into the property market? Well, Queen Elizabeth II's only residence outside of the United Kingdom is finally on the market.
But you will need to save your pennies, because her Malta property, it's going to go for probably around $10 million.
Oh, wow.
And for more on this, we are joined by Royal Insider Martin Townsend. A very good evening to you, I should say. Now, this place has sentimental value for the Queen.
And yeah, very, very fond memories of it. So she'll be sad to see it auctioned, I'm sure.
It'll be interesting. We'll watch that, see which oligarch picks up the Malta property for $10 million.
Yuri will do it. Yeah. Thanks, Martin. Good to see you. Still to come, why it's harder to get away with serial murders in the era of smartphones. And what do you call a fake noodle? An impasta.
Oh, no.
Hey, take it easy. I'm defending the dad jokes this morning, all right?
Okay, so stop right now. We have breaking news. The Spice Girls have announced that they are on their way down under. Mel B letting it slip during the finale of their latest world tour show.
Was Hans there again?
I assume it was deliberate.
Yeah.
You know, it's these things don't happen by accident, do they?
Yeah, but I'll just kind of say something by accident, though. Like,
yeah,
maybe
last time she did
was
that,
just
the Spice Girls got back together.
Okay, well, you know
so,
more than me.
You know.
You're in this world, this music entertainment world.
What is this world?
It is.
You're stirring up the judgment and you're wiping it off and you're looking at me.
You have a hotline to the Spice Girls and you can get the answer. I feel like you would know that kind of stuff.
I wish I did.
In which I hold you, David.
No, see, you've actually you spun that around.
She's backpedaling. I don't believe a word what's coming out of her mouth.
Maybe you should get some other news then and see how you're going in that news world.
Real news. There is quite a bit of real news around this morning. We'll start in Melbourne because a brawl has broken out at an AFL match with rival fans clashing at Marvel Stadium after the Carlton Western Bulldogs game. Police are investigating the incident, but no charges have been laid. It is just the latest in a string of violent fan incidents which have prompted calls for increased security at games. Universal Music is being accused of a major cover-up after revelations master recordings from some of the biggest names in music were destroyed in a fire more than 10 years ago. Live now, tonight's US correspondent Charles Croucher. Good morning to you, Charles. Which musicians have been caught up in this? Charles Croucher, thank you. An experienced pilot has been killed after losing control of his stunt plane and crashing into a river in Poland. The man was performing in an air show when he lost control. The plane free fell 8 metres, slamming into the water. It's not yet clear what caused the plane to malfunction. Well, proving that you should never let the fox guard the hen house, a passerby has captured the moment a pretty mischievous fox found its way into a discount shop in London. Owners, no doubt, arriving to find a bit of a mess.
Cheeky Mr. Fox. Bless you there to Ali as well.
Sneeze. I couldn't say bless you, I was reading, but yeah. I meant it.
Thank She's allergic to foxes.
I kind of like sort of half swallowed it, which is why it sounded a little odd.
Mm. Oh, nice.
No. You didn't really need to know that this morning, did you?
Sorry. But we do now.
It's all right.
Hi, Clint.
Good morning to you again from Melbourne. Yeah, what about that? The magic of television, hey? Goodness. Could be forgiven for thinking we're at Mount Buller. No, we're at Federation Square, though. The Winter Village is open here right through until the end of September, so make sure you get on down. Let's check in on some sport, though, and we start with the Cricket World Cup because Sri Lanka looked on track to chase the highest ever total, getting to 115 without loss before Mitch Stark finally struck. And that for the time being, Ali and David is the latest sport from Melbourne.
Let it snow, Clint. It'd
be better if you...
Let it snow.
Not me.
No, we've got it for you, buddy.
Yeah.
Speaking of snow, I wonder if it's snowing where Tim is.
He's probably...
Sporty Spice.
A few more lunges, everybody. Yeah, I know. No, Bo,
that's a squat,
we're on the television.
Lunge.
Let's not talk about my training regime right now.
Him.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to Mrs. Macquarie's chair. Bo Ryan just putting me in it right here.
Anyway, thanks, dear.
Well, they're the crimes that changed the country, but could we be seeing the end of serial killers?
Well, experts are saying that this tech world we now live in is making it harder for multiple murderers to get away with their crimes for so long. Criminologist Dr. Xanthi Mallett joins us again now. Xanthi, great to see you.
Good
so,
morning.
I mean, do you think if serial murderers like Ivan Milat were acting now, that they could go as undiscovered for so long?
I think it's certainly going to be harder for them with advances in intelligence techniques, for example, criminal profiling, geographic profiling, forensic techniques, DNA, fingerprints. It's going to be harder for people to get away with it for as long as Milat did.
I mean, can you honestly say that we won't see another serial killer?
Well, I would never say that.
But how dangerous can that be, these social media platforms, because it is just automatically takes you to what looks like your favouriting?
It can be really dangerous, especially for young people who are vulnerable, who have become disenfranchised maybe, quite isolated.
Oh, I'm seeing this more and more, it must be true.
Yeah, exactly. And when you don't have any other influences to kind of prevent that taking over, it can be very dangerous for people who are, you know, highly influential, like young, vulnerable people. Mm. Yeah, I mean, mine's always shopping down the side.
It's probably easier said than done, though, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, I think you can change it, but it does take time. You have to be really active in changing it. Right. Xanthi, good to have you on.
Thank you.
Still to come, an ex-detective takes us inside the cult known as The Family.
And U2, Elton John, Fleetwood Mac and Kiss, the stars selling out stadiums down under in the next 6 months.
The must-see Sunday of the year. The Backpacker. taken by a madman.
A filthy pig shed in the middle of nowhere.
What she did next will blow your mind.
Oh, yes, that is our esteemed weather presenter, Tim Davies, there, and sound recorder Simon Carr, not realising the cameraman was filming. So Tim should know by now.
Like, how good's this? How good's this chicken neck dance?
On a stage, too, no less.
On a stage, just doing a bit of... Where's the move where they really get into each other? You know when you lock eyes with your mate in the dance floor?
Here we go.
Mate, how good is this, mate? Yeah, and the chin goes. Fantastic.
And keeping in mind, there was no music at the time, so which makes it even greater.
They're dancing to their own music inside.
Aww. I can't wait to tell Tim that we just aired that.
And we will.
Happy with us.
Yeah. All right, let's get some news now. Jayne.
A man has been found dead after a landslide caused a mine to collapse in Chile. The entrance to the copper mine became blocked, trapping the workers inside. One has been rescued, but a third is still missing. Rescue crews worked for nearly 2 days to locate the trio, who were stuck nearly 100 metres below ground. And stop right now, we have some massive news for you this morning. The Spice Girls have announced they are on their way down under. Mel B letting it slip during the finale of their latest world tour show. There are thousands of Spice Girl fans all around the country.
I don't
very
want people to freak out, though. I mean, she could have said, have you seen that latest movie about Godzilla? I mean, there's a few things she could have said there. Is it confirmed?
Oh, come on.
It's confirmed.
Well, I've just said it in my news.
You
don't
you
believe me?
It's confirmed.
You're confirmed.
I just don't want to get my hopes up again by a Spice Girl.
By a Spice Girl.
Yeah. Oh. I prefer that than being crushed by sport. What about you, Clint?
Yes, cannot wait to see the Spice Girls.
All right, see you then, Clint. Challenge accepted, I reckon.
See ya.
All right, let's check in now with Tim Davies. He's in Sydney for us this morning.
We're just going to stand by here and wait for those guys to come on by and lovingly chuck some water on them as they come past, just to hydrate them as if they're not wet enough already. See you soon.
So you're officially the water boy now. That's good, Tim. Don't drink it all. They need it. They need their sustenance. All right, thanks, buddy. Now, it was the biggest cult in Australian history.
The family was led by Anne Hamilton Byrne, who stole hundreds of children and kept them in a secluded house just outside of Melbourne in the 80s.
The infamous leader died this week, aged 98. And former Detective Lex DeMann, who worked on this case, joins us now from Melbourne. Good morning to you. I think the first question that most people are thinking is, how could she not have served jail time for what she did?
Yeah, good morning, Jayne. Yeah, that's a question that will live with me for the rest of my life.
Can I ask, how are her victims today?
I don't call them victims. They're actually survivors, and they're an amazing group of young people.
Will her death give them some relief?
A number of them feel relieved.
Well, it's absolutely harrowing, and Lex DeMann, we appreciate your time with us this morning. Well, still to come, do we need to rethink arresting low-risk bail offenders? The top cop who's saying they should get off scot-free.
And what do you call a cheese that isn't yours? Nacho cheese. Yeah, dad jokes are back, man, and we are defending them this morning.
Well, making news this morning, Queensland Police Commissioner Ian Stewart has sparked debate after suggesting greater leniency for those who breach bail conditions. And joining us to discuss is Brendan Jones. He's here in the studio with us.
I am. Hello.
You are physically here.
I'm here, man.
Greetings.
And Robin Bailey, who's in Brisbane
who's
this
not
morning.
There, she's but here. In Queensland.
Hey, Robin, what are your thoughts on this one?
I would suggest it's a frustration he's had for a really long time, and I would much prefer to hear it from a policeman who knows what they're talking about than, say, a politician suggesting that. So for that alone, it gives it credibility.
Gives it credibility and gives it weight, Jonesy. What do you think about this? There'll be a lot of people who are out there going, well, if you do the crime, you've got to do the time.
Sure. But they're already letting guys with much serious offences walk on bail, so why not just let everyone roam free? Have you noticed that?
All right, well, let us know what you think about that one, because that could divide a lot of people out there. But also making news this morning, kids could choose where they want to live. The reverse custody plan would see divorced parents taking turns living in the marital home with kids staying put. So, Jonesy, should mums and dads be the one to have to move around here?
Yeah, I think so. I think the kids for too long have been just used as pawns in a, you know, a game of chess where no one is the winner.
But I guess your problem here is if you're letting kids choose, you've got, Robin, I'll bring you in on this, is, I mean, we don't always know what's happening behind the scenes, you know, if the kids are being manipulated. This is, you know, one parent going, hey, you know what, there's no limit on screen time if you come and, I mean, who knows?
Then what they do at the other parent's place kind of stops becoming any of your business. And that's the reality. Because I think there is so much trauma around divorce, particularly if it's got so nasty that a judge has to sort it out. Mm. You know, we've got to think of the kids.
That kind of leads into this, doesn't it, that Kramer versus Kramer joke? Because yes. Dads are fighting back against claims that their jokes are lame. You know what, when a dad makes a joke, we don't care if it's funny to you or not.
Jonesy, you are the dad in this scenario and so are you, DC.
I imagine
so
he's a dad with a
I've just got material. I've got A grade.
Tell us your material.
Okay. How do you get an elephant into a Safeway bag?
How?
You take the F out of safe and the F out of way.
Oh, okay.
Go, think of, let's say, yeah. So you take the...
Yeah,
F out of safe.
Yeah, okay.
And now the F out of
when
way.
You're explaining the jokes.
Okay.
Try another one.
Hey, that's good. You've got to say it. You've got to complete it. So okay. Come on. Because there's no...
F Jonesy.
Out of safe. The F out of way.
And the F... There's no F in way.
Exactly. I couldn't say it, but Alice and Langdon from 60 Minutes just said it. Boom. On TV. You made it sound like a Jedi mind trick of a dad joke. And I saw you fall into it. And I'm like, whoa. No. And anyway, it was nice working with you.
This has been great. See you, Langdon.
I'll never forgive you for
that. I can't believe you felt like that. That was in my heart. It's in my mouth. It's the best.
Thanks,
until
guys.
Next time.
See ya.
Well, still to come, the artist planning to sue Universal Music Group over recordings destroyed in a 2008 fire. We've moved on.
And then the homegrown talent set to take stage at this year's Logie Awards. I wonder who we're talking about.
Welcome back. It's news time now. An ugly all-in brawl has broken out at an AFL match in Melbourne. Opposing fans coming to blows at Marvel Stadium after the Carlton Western Bulldogs game. Police are investigating the incident, but no charges have been laid. Now I want to take you to some live pictures that are coming in from our Nine News helicopter showing Australia's longest-serving Navy ship, the HMAS Success, pulling into Sydney Harbour on its final voyage. The vessel is on its last journey from Cairns with hundreds of sailors on board. It will be decommissioned later this month. Spectacular pictures coming through the Sydney Heads there. And just imagine all the sailors on board. They must be feeling pretty good about heading home. And finally, homegrown talent will be the focus of performances at this year's Logies with Aussie legends Delta Goodrum, Guy Sebastian and Jessica Malboy all gracing the stage. And that is the day's news, so it's over to Clint with the sport.
DC, I've got my trusty mate Alex, Alex Cecile. I thought you'd like that one. I'm going to go for a bit of a spin on the ice. Just remember, one of the most uncoordinated... we don't need that, surely.
Yeah.
Nika.
Oh.
Talk with...
No, you don't need it.
Yeah. Nah, you're doing great.
Jeez. Oh, righto.
We're so supportive of each other on the show, aren't we?
This has got accident written all over it, mate. It's got,
I don't know. I think you're getting the hang of it.
It's got Tonya Hardy.
Yeah. I mean, are you okay?
Wow. Just broken two ankles.
I don't think we need to do anything else. Just leave it on this for a while longer. Maybe the next 20 minutes. You're right.
It's quite tiring, actually, isn't it?
Oh, instant replay.
Instant
straight into the video ref.
Clint, we're watching it on slow-mo.
Oh, good, good.
Good luck, Clint. Don't lose.
Glad I've been able to give you some enjoyment. See ya.
Yeah, good on you, mate.
He's getting again.
Oh, no, he's okay. Now he's stopped.
All right, let's check in now with... We'll leave him in peace.
Oh, look out. Here's Tim.
Woo!
well done, everybody. Guys, you came to us just at the right time. 4Ks, how was that for you, Bo?
It was probably a little bit harder than I thought. Sorry, I just elbowed someone in the face. It was harder than I thought, but where else would you want to be on a Sunday morning?
Oh, exactly.
Well, coming up next, what's it like being caught in the middle of an epic feud with Kelly Rowland and Boy George? We'll tell you. So take a look.
There's $60,000 up for grabs tomorrow. To be in the running, you're going to need the code word RAINBOW. Well, you can call, you can text the numbers on your screen, and remember, you don't have to say the code word RAINBOW. You just need to say, I wake up with today, and we call you on the phone.
Oh,
I just wanted your attention.
You got our attention.
You're welcome.
And a very good Sunday morning to you.
Bye, Felicia.